Good morning students, I am Sudipta, your English teacher, and today I'll discuss a new lesson from your grammar book, Tune into Grammar. From this book, I'll discuss open at chapter number 2, and it is pronouns. Okay, it is pronouns. So it is for class 7 students only, and today I'll discuss the first part from this chapter, and gradually I will make you clear about pronouns and all those questions. Okay, so let's begin. Today's lesson is for class 7, and the name of the chapter is pronouns. Okay, I'll discuss the classification with examples. It is for class 7 students. It is chapter 2, and today I'll discuss the first part only. Okay, so let's begin. Just look at this paragraph and read this paragraph very carefully, okay, so that you will be understand what is pronoun, how it is different from noun, how you will be able to use pronoun in your own sentence. Okay, so let's go through this paragraph. Okay, so Rahul is my friend. Here a boy whose name is Rahul. So you must know Rahul is a name. So can you tell me Rahul is noun? What type of noun it is? What type of noun? It is proper noun, because previously I told you every type of name in this world, such as Rahul, such as Salman, such as Sachin Tendulkar, such as Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, PM Narendra Modi, each and every name is a proper noun. So in this paragraph, the first word, that is Rahul, is proper noun. It is not directly connected to pronoun, but you must know it. Okay, so let's begin. Rahul is my friend. Rahul loves cooking. Rahul's father is a businessman. Rahul's mother is a teacher in charge in a very reputed school in Raipur. Rahul's mother loves Rahul more than Rahul's father does. So here you are watching, you are noticing that in this paragraph, Rahul, this name has come repeatedly more than 2 to 5 times. Okay, so if you are pronouncing this particular name of a boy or a girl, so it creates a monotony. So it is a repetition. So the charm will not come whenever you tell this the same name repeatedly, again and again. So Rahul is my friend. Rahul loves cooking. Rahul's father is a businessman. Rahul's mother is a teacher in charge in a very reputed school in Raipur. Rahul's mother loves Rahul more than Rahul's father does. So here Rahul, the same name, the particular name you are telling repeatedly. So it is a matter of monotony. So how it can be solved? Yes, if you want to solve this monotony, you have to use pronouns. Okay, so let's see how pronoun can be used here. Here Rahul, next Rahul's, again Rahul, next Rahul's, next Rahul's, and finally Rahul, next again Rahul's. So I will make this sentence differently so that it would be a good one. Okay, so let's see here. Rahul is my friend. He loves cooking. So instead of Rahul, I use here he. His father is a businessman. So whose father? Rahul's father. So I am not using the same name Rahul here. Instead of Rahul, I have written his, means the Rahul and he is the same person. Okay, the next line, his mother is a teacher in charge in a very reputed school in Raipur. So whose mother? Rahul's mother. Still I am not using Rahul, the same name here, but instead of Rahul I am using here his mother. Okay, again, his mother loves him more than his father does. So previously what was there? Rahul's mother loves Rahul more than Rahul's father does. So instead of Rahul, again I am using his mother loves him more than his father does. So definitely the second paragraph, means this paragraph, sounds better than that was meant possibly by using he, his, him instead of Rahul. Okay, so here he, his, him, his. These words are used instead of Rahul, instead of a noun. So in this sentence, when we use those words instead of a noun to avoid the monotony and the repetition of that similar noun again and again, those words are called pronouns. Okay, so let's see what is next. Here, definition of pronoun. Definition means what is pronoun, what is there in pronoun, what is the main characteristics of pronoun. In a single sentence, what is pronoun? That is called the definition. Okay, so the definition is here. Pronouns are used to replace a noun. Previously, you noticed that pronouns were used instead of Rahul. So replace a noun. So the name was the noun, the Rahul, the name, it was replaced by him, his, whatever. So pronouns are used to replace a noun with, for the sake of avoiding monotony, repetition. Okay, so here, according to J.C. Nesfield. So who is J.C. Nesfield? I'll tell you who is J.C. Nesfield. Before that, there was also a very important definition of noun. That is, very important definition of pronoun. That is, a pronoun is a word used instead of a noun or noun equivalent. This example was made, or this definition was made by J.C. Nesfield. J.C. Nesfield is one of the greatest grammar composers. in this world. He was from England, okay? And he went West Bengal, and he was the English lecturer or the professor in Cottage Church College. So he was a very, very big personality, a very big person. He was a very important person. He was a very famous grammar composer. Name is J.C. Nesfield. So according to J.C. Nesfield, a pronoun is a word used instead of a noun or noun equivalent. Okay? So next, here is the diagram of pronouns. Okay, so pronouns are nine types of pronouns are there in our English grammar. So the first is personal pronoun, second is possessive pronoun, third is interrogative pronoun, fourth is relative pronoun, fifth is demonstrative pronoun, sixth is emphatic pronoun, seventh is reflexive pronoun, eighth is distributive pronoun, and nine is indefinite pronoun. So I'll tell you later on, step by step, so that you will be cleared about the pronouns. And students, this chapter is very, very important. This chapter is very, very important, not only for your test, not only for your standard of your class in which you are studying now, but it is very important through all your life, because this chapter, if you are very conscious, if you are very learned over this chapter pronoun, so in the future it will help you a lot. Okay, so next, see what is next. Here, the first pronoun, that is personal pronoun. So what is personal pronoun? Personal pronouns are those pronouns that stand for persons. Personal pronouns are that pronouns that stand for persons. Persons means I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are called personal pronouns. But personal pronouns depend on more than two very important points, that is gender and number. So I am going to explain you what is the role of gender, what is the role of number, and what is the role of person to use of personal pronouns. Just have a look. So here we use personal pronoun depending upon the number, gender, and person. So at first I'll discuss a little about number. So what is number? Number means a single thing, that is one, and more than one is called plural. Okay, so I have a pen, that is singular. If there are so many pen, so I should call it there are many pens. So pen to pens, singular to plural. Okay, so numbers, some examples are there in front of you, that is singular, that is red colored letter, and plural, that is white colored letters. So now boat is a singular, and one boat is it is singular, and more than one boats, it is plural. House is singular, houses, it is plural. So generally we use S or ES to make singular to plural. Okay, so house to houses, cat, C-A-T, cat, two cats, I mean one cat, one singular cat is one single cat is cat, more than one cat is cats. River, one river, more than one river is rivers, such as bus, B-U-S, bus, that is buses, B-U-S-E-S. Wish, W-I-S-H, wish, wish to wishes. Peach, P-I-T-C-H, peach, one type of fruit. Peach to peaches, P-I-T-C-H-E-S. Box, B-O-X, box, box to boxes. So you have to learn a lot about number, you have to learn it, you have to read again and again so that you will keep those words in your mind properly. Okay, you have to learn again and again. So here is a little example or a short introduction about number, because number is coming from in the chapter of noun. So you are in the standard of 7, so there is no such influence of number or gender in your syllabus, so that I am not explaining here more about number. Okay, so let's see what is next. Yes, that is gender. Gender means male, female. There are four types of gender. I'll tell you. So what is gender? In our Indian language, such as in Hindi, jaisa ladka, ladki. Ladka is masculine gender, that is male. Ladki is from feminine gender, which is called female. Okay, and in English also there gender, that is boy is male and girl is female. So there are four types of gender. One is masculine gender. Masculine, what is masculine gender? Masculine gender is a noun that shows male subtype, is known as masculine gender. That is, for example, king. King, definitely a male. Man, definitely it is male. Boy, it is male. Father, cock, bull, fox, those are male subcategory or subtype. Those words or those genders are called masculine gender. Okay, next, the feminine gender. Here is the feminine gender. So what is the definition of feminine gender? A noun that shows female subtype is known as feminine gender, such as queen. So king was the masculine gender, that is male. Queen is the feminine gender, that is female. Such as man is masculine gender, woman, that is feminine gender. Boy, masculine gender, girl, feminine gender or female. Such as father to mother, cock to hen, bull to cow, and fox to vixen. Fox is masculine or it is male, and the feminine gender of fox is vixen. Okay, just put it in your mind. Next, the next gender is neuter gender. It is very, very important. Neuter gender, what is the What is the definition of neuter gender? Neuter gender is the third gender, that is, some nouns are neither male nor female. They all under the neuter gender. Okay? Such as table. Table has no gender. It is neuter gender. Here, H-A-I-R, here, this is my here. Here has no gender, such as city. City has no gender. Cinema hall, multi-complex, almira, basket, pin, curtain, window, door. This subtype of things are called neuter gender, which are not coming from any male or female category. Okay, so it is the third category from gender. Now the fourth and last category from gender, that is common gender. What is common gender? Unlike neuter gender, certain nouns are stands for both male and female. They are called common gender, such as teacher. Okay, so it would be male teacher, it would be female teacher, it doesn't matter, but teacher means they may be both male or female, you can't distinguish it. So student, okay, student in English, student means both male student or female student. There is no distinction about student, such as cousin, parent, baby, etc. Those have common gender, those had common in sense, and those nouns are called common gender. Okay, so here are four types of gender. You have to remember it. If you want to write, must write it in your class copy. Okay, next. Next is person. It is very, very important to compose a sentence. Each and every portion from our grammar is very, very important to compose or to write a correct sentence. So here, persons are three types. First is first person, second person, and third person. What is first person? I'm going to tell you. A first person which denotes the person or person spoken, I, my, me, we, our, etc. Okay? Such as, I am the best. So it is I am always best. I means wo khud. Hindi mein kya kehte hai? Wo khud. Main, matlab main khud. I am the best. Main kisi se kam nahi. So in this sense, I am the best. My father is a Navy officer. So my is also the first person. I am not telling about the pronoun. Okay? It is the person. But if I am going to explain my, what is the from which group my is situated, so it is some another question. So I am telling you what is first person, what is second person, what is third person, and after that I'll tell you that I, my, mine, ours, this type of pronouns which will come. I definitely tell you next step by step. So I, next, we are going to school. So here I, my, we, those are related to I. Okay, so read the note. What is the note? The note is those person related to I are the first person. Those persons such as I, my, me, our, we, ours, mine, those are fast person. Clear? Okay. So next, go to the next page. It should be second person, I think. Yes, definitely. It is second person. And what is second person? I means me. And second person, you, tum. In Hindi, tum. Me, I, first person. You, tum, second person. Okay? The second person which denotes the person or person spoken to you, thou, your, yours, etc. Example, you are a good boy. My father is a Navy officer. Sorry, your father is a Navy officer. You are going to play football. So here you and all those pronouns, all those persons, all those words which are coming from you, make sure that were from second person. Okay, so what is the note? Those persons related to you are the second person. Second person means tum, in English you. Next, it should be third person. Yes, it is third person. So what is third person? Except me, except I and you, all those things are here in our world. Those are third person. Mujhe aur tumko chhodke jitna sare sab kuch hai tumhare aankhon ke samne, wo sabhi third person hai. Ye Tata board, ye kya hai? Third person hai. Ye pen kya hai? What is this? It is third person. The Tata board is third person. The wristwatch, third person. The book, third person. Because it is not coming from I and you. Okay? This duster, it is from third person. It's a battery. It is third person. It is a piece of chalk. It is third person. So everything which is not connected, which is not coming from first person and second person, those are third person. It is very simple. Okay? So the third person which denotes the person or person spoken of, he, she, it, they, there. He lives in a palace. She loves flowers. It is all right. So those person related other than I and you are the third person. So mujhe, I, main, I or tum, you. Isko chhodke jitna sara cheez hamare duniya mein hai, wo sabhi cheez third person se belong karta hai. Okay? Is it clear to you? It is very easy. Next. So, first person, second person, third person, person is completed, I think. Yes, I'll definitely discuss in a broad way in the special chapter of person, but here I'm going to just give the idea to understand the pronoun. Okay, so you have seen that pronouns, personal pronouns are depending upon first is number, gender and person. Okay, so here is a table. It is a table of first person, second person and third person. So you will be able to know and just have a look on the table so that each and every confusion which may arise later, it would be clear to you. Okay, so the first person, the first row, that is my left hand side, the first row, that is person, first person, second person and third person. And the middle, in the middle there is a row, that is number row. And the last row, my right hand side, that is the pronoun. So first person, the singular number, The pronoun is I. The first person plural number, the pronoun is ui. Second person singular number, pronoun is you. Second person plural is you. Third person singular number, masculine, that is he. Third person singular number, feminine or female, that is she. And third person singular number, neuter gender, that is it. And third person plural, that is they. He, she, it, that is singular from third person, and they have one in only plural, that is they, T-H-E-Y. It is so easy. Okay, so the chart is here, so that every time just open the video, just have the chart, and there all the confusion will be clear to you, I think. Next, it was the personal pronoun, that is I, we, you, you, he, she, it, and they. It was personal pronoun. Okay, is it clear? So now next is possessive pronoun. Possessive means what? It is possession. Ye cheez meri hai ya mera hai. It says something belonging to you. Okay? So here is the definition of possessive pronoun. A pronoun indicates possession. For example, mine, yours, hers, theirs. So those are the example of possessive pronoun. Here are some examples here. The sentence: this book is mine. Always keep this word in your mind, that possessive pronoun must be used at the end of the sentence, such as this book is mine. So here mine is possessive pronoun. It is yours. Yours is possessive pronoun. This book is mine means ye book mera hai. It is yours means ye hai tumhara. That car was theirs. Ye car un logo ke the. Theek hai? Then next. So here is also a table. Table is possessive, or it is a case. It is called possessive case, so that you will be able that what is the form of possessive, such as first person the pronoun I and the possessive is mine. First person plural, that is ui, and the possessive form of ui is ours, such as second person singular number you. The possessive form is yours. The same possessive form from plural, that is you, and the possessive form is yours, such as third person singular number he. The possessive form is his. Third person singular number feminine gender, that is she, and the possessive pronoun is hers. Third person neuter gender singular number, the pronoun is it, and the possessive pronoun is its. Third person they plural, and the possessive is theirs. So in this way we will use these words at the end of the sentence. Now next, here is the pronoun, that is interrogative pronoun. So what is the meaning of interrogative? Interrogation, you must have this word interrogation, means to ask something. It is a query, to ask. Somebody wants to know something, that is called interrogation, and this is interrogative pronoun. So here is the definition of interrogative pronoun, that is, an interrogative pronoun is a pronoun which asks a question, such as who, which, what, whose, and whom. Here are some examples, such as who. How, who is used in a sentence. Who are you? It is a sentence, it is a question. Who are you? Which is your bag? It is also a question. What do you want? It is also a question. So interrogative pronoun creates a question. Okay, interrogative pronouns are mainly WH words. WH means who, which, what, how, when, where. W and H, whose, the first two letters are W and H. So it is the family of WH. So these words are called WH words. Okay, so interrogative pronouns are who, which, what. This type of words are called interrogative pronouns. Now next, I'll tell you some different uses of interrogative pronouns. Here, interrogative pronouns are also used to ask indirect question, such as tell me what you want. It is also a question, but there should not be used any question marks at the end of the sentence. I asked who he was. It is also who. It is the interrogative pronoun. Next, who is applied to person is indefinite. Means who goes there? Actually, you don't know the person. In the darkness, he is going, and we normally use this type of sentence. Who are you? Who is going there? Okay, so it is used in this way. Which is applied to both persons and things and refers to one out of a group. Which of these books do you want? So which, when we use which, when we want to select a particular person or a particular thing within a group. Okay, next, what. What is applied to person and things also, such as what we want, what he is. What he is means what is his occupation, what is his profession. Okay, so here is the different use of interrogative pronouns. So up to this, it would be your lesson today, and here I am going to complete this first part. Here is the end of first part. It is pronoun. So there are 6 pronouns are still left to be discussed. Okay. So next, gradually, step by step, I'll come in front of you, and I want to make you understand what are the various types of pronouns. Okay, so till then, bye bye. Stay safe at your home, just focus on your study. Till then, goodbye, bye bye.